Hi, I'm here with Marla Sauceville in Studio 222. We're going to talk about how to clean up terracotta in studio efficiently. The goal is to do this in under 10 minutes with 25 students in the room. Let's see if we can make that goal. Five responsibilities. Each person at your table is going to take on one as a lead, and then, of course, everyone's going to need to wash their hands. So, first thing Marla's going to demonstrate is the wrapping. The wrapping person is, everybody is going to need to drape their warrior with a damp paper towel. Now, I'm not saying a wet paper towel, I'm saying damp, and it's okay to use a dirty paper towel when you do this. So she's dipped it in the water and she's squeezing it out. This is the same paper towel she used yesterday. She's going to lay it across her warrior, almost like a mummy or a blanket, tucking it in. And the point of this is to keep the clay not wet, but moist while you're not working on it. So each person's going to be responsible for this, and then they're going to do the rest of their work. Marlo is then going to take all four sculptures and line them up on a Masonite drawing board. So you'll notice that we're going to have our names across the mummies. She's going to put four on the board. I'm going to go and help her because this then becomes quite heavy, and she'll need help getting the plastic over the board. Perfect. Perfect. And we want to squeeze out all the air. And the great thing about these plastic bags is they really take the shape of what's in the bag. We're going to fold it over, put the table number on top, then the person who's in charge of wrapping will place it on the rack that's labeled for your table. All right, next responsibility. Marla, can you check that one off for us, please? One down. Okay, next step is cleaning up the tools and the slip. So that is going to require putting the lids on the containers, making sure the tools are all together, and then carrying them over to the sink in two trips, and placing them at the back of your table's sink so they'll be ready for the next class. If the tools are really filthy, you need to take to the sink and rinse them, and then lay them across the bucket of water at the back of the sink. Perfect, Marlo. Well done. Okay. Once that's done, the tablecloth person can take on their job. We're going to wash the table down with a clean sponge. Of course, we're wiping up dirt, so the sponge is going to get dirty as you're working, and you may need to go to the sink and rinse it before you're through. Most likely you'll need to. Please do so that it's definitely clean for the next class. Marla's doing an excellent job. She's very thorough. Once she has it clean, she is going to fold it up now. Okay, she's ready to fold the tablecloth now. She grabs it from the center. Now it's in half. She lays it down. She folds it in half again. Now it's quartered. It's perfect. Easy to toss over the clothesline in the room. Got tablecloth done. Check. Each person's going to have to wash their hands once they've completed their responsibility. Ideally, there shouldn't be more than one person from your table at the sink at a time. It should take all of that 10, 15 seconds to do that. Then we're going to take the smocks off. You can temporarily lay your smock over the back of your chair. But eventually, the smock person at your table is going to put them on a hanger, hang them on the garment rack so they're dry for the next class. Perfect, Marlo. Excellent. And that's it. Bing!
That was 5 minutes.
Perfect. Thank you.